So in this video, you will see how we can edit the rows inside the query editor. So in the last video, you have seen about the basic introduction of query editor and you have go through on the query editor. So here we will see two options, first for the keep rows and second for the remove rows. So in the keep rows, we will see five options. First for the keep top rows, keep bottom rows, keep range of rows, keep duplicate rows, keep error rows. And inside the remove rows, you will again see the five options. First for the remove top rows, remove bottom rows, remove range of rows, then remove duplicate rows, then remove error rows. So you will see these options. Let's move to Power BI Desktop. And here, as we seen in the last video, we have loaded these three files inside the query editor. So here, as we can see, the first file, that is Australia. So first row and second row is not the correct as we are expecting. So these two is a dummy rows for us. So we just want to remove these two rows. So for that, we will have an option for remove top rows. So before going to remove top rows, here go to on home ribbon and reduce rows. Here we have keep rows and remove rows. Inside the keep rows, we are having five options as I told you, and in the remove rows again we are having five options. So we just want to remove top two rows. So for that, we can use remove top rows. We can select two and click on OK. So here, as we can see, top two rows has been removed. And in the applied steps, we can see we are having this remove top rows. And if we did any mistake, then we can directly cancel this and our last step and data will be stored as last step we did. So here we just want to remove top two rows. So we can again remove top rows and two. Now looks good. After that, here we can see the first row, that is not the data row. It should be the header. So for that, here we are having for option use first row as header, or go to on transform ribbon, and here we are having this option use first row as header. So we can click on this, and in the applied step, it is added two steps, first for the promote headers and second for the change type. So in the Power BI latest version, we will see these options for change type automatically. So it will detect the data type of the columns automatically and this step will be added. So just cancel this. We will do in the later. After that, again we can see we are having these blank rows. So these are not the correct as we want. So we just want to remove these blank rows. So how we can do this? So for that, go to on home ribbon, go to on remove rows. Here we are having for remove blank rows. So once we remove this, then we can see we have removed this data. And now we can see we are having this NA over here. So these are not the correct. So we just want to remove these NAs from the table. So how we can do this? So go to on remove rows. If we remove the error, then it will not be worked because these are not the error rows. Just do it and we'll see. So step is added, but NA is here because these are the string values, like character values for NA. So these are not the errors. So just remove it. We can filter those rows which are not required for us. So for that, we can use NA and just unselect this and click on OK. So we will see we have removed the NAs. But I would not recommend to use the search option for the filtering rows, because if anything is having like NA, like any character which is containing NA, that will also be unselected. Here we are having the integer values, that's why I have used it and it's working fine. But if you will have any string values and that may have the NA in the other characters, so that will be unselected. So I would suggest don't use this search for filtering the rows. Now it looks good and we made a great progress. After that, just moved to on UK, and here again we just want to remove these two top rows. So go to on remove rows, remove top rows and two. Now click on OK. So top rows is removed. Here we just want to promote the header as the first row. So we can use this option. So this is promoted and this step is added. So we just want to cancel it. And here again we can see we are having these blank rows. So we just want to remove these blank rows. So go to on remove rows, remove blank rows. So now it looks good and we made a great progress. Now go to on US, and inside the US again we just want to remove top two rows. So here we can select two. Now click on OK. After that we just want to promote the header. An extra step is added, so we just want to cancel this. So after that we just want to remove these NA. So again we can use the search option for us, but I would not recommend to use it if we are having the character data type for the column. Now click on OK. That looks good and we have edited the rows. So what we have learned in this video, we have learned how we can remove the rows. And in the keep rows, if we want to use the keep top rows, so go to keep top rows, we just want to keep top 10 rows. So we can select, and here we can set the number of rows as 10. Now click on OK. So here we are having only top 10 rows, other rows are removed, so we don't want to use it. And in the keep bottom rows, so data will be in this table from the bottom, and we can select the number, so how many rows we want. After that, keep range of rows, so here first row and number of row. So we just want to start from 2 and we want only 2 rows. So it will start from 2 and we'll have only 2 rows. So this is for range of rows. After that we can see keep duplicates. It will keep the duplicate values only. After that keep error. If we will have any error rows in the table, so it will keep only those. So this is for the editing rows. So I hope you have understand how we can edit the rows. So in the next video we will see how we can append these three tables, because our output should be a single table. So in the next video we will see how we can get the single table. So thank you so much for watching this video. See you there. Thank you.